Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to BatSponge Gaming. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. It's been a while since I made a video. So I'm making one now. Oh, I'm not going to do this. Crap. Where are the torches? Where'd I put the torches? No idea. I'll come here for the Lord. Yes, it's been a while since I made a Minecraft video. Although, I think I uploaded one not long ago. I think it was just before Christmas that the last one went up. Or just before December, I think it was. And a lot has happened since then. A lot has gone down. A lot has presented itself, as it were, by and large. Christmas has happened. New Year has happened. My dad, unfortunately, passed away just before Christmas. All these things have come to triers and but I am back and hopefully we will be playing a bit of Minecraft for a bit in between. I'm currently starting a business up with a friend, and that will probably be taking our time to a large extent, but until it's starting, all the seminars and things and lectures and bits and bobs we've been to basically say the businesses don't make money in the first year or so. We'll probably have a quiet year and hopes to get it all sorted and starting. So there'll probably be gameage between then. But a few things have happened on the server. I don't know if you remember the underneath area that I wanted to turn into, like, the farming area and the tree farm area and where to put the animals. Well, one day I came on and I decapitated a lot of it, a large area. I basically smoothed down a whole little section of it. As you can see, the walls are now built. All of them. However, I only went down, because bear in mind it's a huge area, I only went down like four to six layers. And I thought, it took me so long to just do those layers and build those walls. I thought, no. Once the walls were complete, I did, and I will admit to being just a skosh. Mind you, not a lot, a skosh, cheaty, and I did the rest in MC edit. I deleted the entire area of the remaining stone, dirt, gravel. I also deleted all the gravel, and other bits and pieces that I'd gotten from digging it out, because I thought, well, you know, I needed the cobble for the walls, but everything else, I thought, well, if I'm MC editing it away, then I really shouldn't keep it for myself. But I did keep all the ores because, well, I want them. So I deleted a lot of stuff, but I also kept some stuff. But I'm going to have to work to get the ores, as you will see. So I've got to get the obsidian to continue the tower. The tower is going to be the platforms, if you remember. So this is going to be the bottom. Then there's going to be, I think, 1, 2, 3 layers to this tower with the central staircase. Then there'll be a second tower and then a third tower on top. And the walls, if you notice up here, you can see them over here. Yeah, there they are. Oh, way too high. Die, you little shit. Yeah, the walls don't touch. So the walls are not going to touch that second tower. So they, because they stop at this tower. So I don't know what to do because, you know, the entire point is the tower is the observation deck for the people running the experiments and the people in the villages. So I'm thinking that what I'll do is the when you saw the outside of the tower, the obsidian, what I might do is fill that with cobble or surround it with cobble. So from the outside, it'll just look like a circular cobble wall in the center. It looks strange, but... And then have that circular wall go all the way up to the top with, like, an observation window in it so that there'll be an observation window, sort of... You'll be able to walk out of that tower and then there'll be an observation window in that wall there. And then the wall will just continue up and then the second tower will start. So each tower will actually have their own little walkout ways. So they'll be... They'll have room. So, yeah. As you can see, this is now... This. My mouse is greasy. I was eating pork chops. My mouse is now very, very greasy. As you see, as I made it so that I'll have to work to get the ores. But for the moment, I need to light the area up, which is what I was doing, getting torches. So if you don't mind me having a bit of a ramble while doing this bit. It's quite high. If you remember, there was mountains all down here. A lot of it I did clear. Like, I think over there, I cleared, like, the entire corner all the way down to the area. But up here, that mountain I didn't touch. I leveled it off a couple of layers. I think I leveled it off to about there-ish. So I chopped it down. I left all the... I mined around the ores. Because I thought, well, I'll leave them there. I'll collect them as a lot of dust. What a prick. As you can see, this place is minorly dangerous. Shane was helping me do it for a bit. We might continue at some point this week. I'll record it if I do. The only problem with it is if, when Shane helps me is I can't record dual audio, so it has to be one file with audio on, because the way I've got it set up is the recording software records the game, the system sound, which is the game and anything else, and then records my microphone separately. Of course, his voice will come out as a system file, so it'll be recorded with the game audio, so I won't be able to win a non-commentary version. So yeah. This gets a little dangerous. Ooh, that's why it gets a little dangerous. Prick. Oh, don't move. How dare you? Oh, he died. I'll take that back. Shane had several... several villagers that he managed to get. And don't you dare even think about a boy. He, one of them, he managed to get mending, sell mending books. And I was like, oh, you village sells mending books? Yeah. Can I get a few? How many? Oh, about five? Yeah, he says, yeah, no problem. And bear in mind, he did agree to it. Yeah. He's like, yeah. I do it. Ooh, I didn't look at you. I go there. You two go back. Ow. Not me. I went there, took the mending books. I took about five. I put one. Some I'd managed to actually get on my own. So I'd gotten a few mending books separately, and I'd managed to get a mending on a few pieces of armor after going through a lot of armor. And so I took the remaining books from his villager, and about a few days later, he was like, you took all my mending books. I went, no. I said, I only traded with the villager a few times. Yeah, you took all my mending books. What? The villagers, he says, don't get their trades back if you take a certain amount. I was like, ah. Whoops. God, this is dangerous. Hey, I didn't look. So yeah, he was mildly irked. Oh, for... so many zombies, it's unbelievable. Now and again, you'd get a really good run. You'd get a really good run when nothing tries to eat your face. And then other times, you get a really shit run. Where everything tries to eat your face. As you can see, it's fucking dangerous. Creepers more than anything else you have to look out for. Strafing the zombies on the skeletons now is ridiculous. Also, they seem to have nerfed them. Oh, yeah. Because before, they didn't miss. They never missed. Now they miss all the time. It's really weird. Skeleton coming up. You know what I mean? It's all the time now. Do I just... It's hard to see in the dark. Right. I hear the pitter-patter. Go away. And you can go away. Future reference. You can fuck off for a start, and then you can fuck off. Ooh, there's a party going on over there. I don't like it. Don't like it. One eye. Ah, shit. Where'd he go? Also, they seem to hit a lot less harder. Put that down, you thieving little scumbag. I did not hear that at all! Fucking creepers pissed me off. Have they literally changed their explodey distance? Because I've had a few blow up while trying to do this, as you can imagine. Fuck off. And they blow up really quickly now. It's as if they've gone, yeah, we'll nerf the skeletons, but we're gonna get the creepers to fuck you. It's one line. You didn't see anything.
Yeah.
Just keep an eye out. I don't know why I'm whispering. Right then, let's have a look. Once this is complete, once I've got the lighting up so that things will stop spawning down here, what I'm going to do is then build the tree farm. And then build the farm. Some cows, some sheep. I swear I got some pigs as well. Why did I pick that up? Come here. Oh, my inventory's small, so I didn't pick it up. Yeah. So I got loads of cows. That's why I keep getting meat from. But I swear I've got some pigs and some whatchamacallums, sheep and stuff somewhere. I swear some spawned. Yeah, you can fuck off. Yeah, stop doing it the wrong place. Oh, they're all Dick Jesus, they really are. Oh, I haven't done any more in that direction. All right, fair enough. Bollocks, I did not see that. Another problem with cheating. I had a quite literally counted away and had a poison spider drop on my bonds. That seemed wrong here. I thought it was. I did one wrong before, and I had to correct the entire bloody line. As long as I don't get wrong in that direction, should be good for the most part. I think it's there. Gotta get a rhythm. That's to get to rhythm. Which I keep going off. Miss me. Miss me. I'm standing still. Oh, they don't have strafe now, I tell you. I think they missed too much now. I don't know why they were nerfed. I thought they were a bit... What you call? I don't know why they've been... fucked. I don't know. I liked them before. They were really, really, really irritating. Perhaps people whinged because of the new combat system. With the new combat system, it's kind of pissy. Which, to be honest, is why I changed to the bow and arrow. Yeah, I see. Because the combat system sucks. I like a lot of the changes that they've been adding to Minecraft. I like the shulker chest, even so I'm going to have to go and get myself one. I like the... what was it? A couple of the new bricks. Miss them. I like the lava blocks, although I don't quite understand them. But the combat system sucks, bollocks. When it came out, I heard a lot of people go, oh, it's because it's the PvP. I don't give a fucking shit. I don't play PvP. Why have they fucked it for PvE? Why is it PvP players get all the extra bonusy Buffy buffs, changing Buffy buff buff changes or Buffy buff buffness, when the PvE people then get shafted? Still got them. Confused then. Right, done. Two rows done. Well, I saw a creeper around here a minute ago. Where is he? There he is. On the off chance he turns around. Gotta go down to the tower and work out where the middle is for the section as well. Because the middle section torches are different from the rest. They don't meet up. The torches are three away from each wall. Because that's how they add up top. They're three away from each wall, and they're perfectly lined, so they're all, every wall, it's three away. Has three torches, three blocks away from the wall, and then all the, there's equal amount of torches in a grid. Down here it doesn't work like that, because I did all the torches over that wall there, and I went all the way up to the top. I actually did it on camera as well, but my recording screwed up. I had a huge problem with the editing software, which I'll tell you about in a bit. Not that you're interested, you know, but I'll tell you anyway. So yeah, I counted, and I was like, why is that wrong? Why isn't it working? And it was because it was up top, there is a wall separating the four quadrants. And down here, there are no walls separating the four quadrants. It's just one big open area. So when I did my torch calculating from that wall to that wall down there, it didn't match. And I got there, and I was like, wait, that's... Oh, shit. Oh, no, it's just these ones here. And I was like, oh, what the fuck? What? What has happened? Why has it happened? And, yes, so what I had to do was do the center from the center of the tower down the middle of each quadrant, and then make sure that the torches then go from there to there. So in each, where the walls are up top, the torches are closer together on either side. Confused the shit out of me for a while. I was like, what's going on? And then I figured it out, and I felt like a complete moron. Yes, I had a bit of a problem come before Christmas. I upscaled to I replaced my monitor because it was broken. And I got a great deal on a guy who was selling a 4K monitor on eBay. And I was like, well, why not? I mean, basically, it's going to be the same price as buying myself a normal monitor, but it's going to be a 4K one. I thought, yeah, go on then. I'll take that. Not realizing the trickiness that would befall me. The 4K monitor doesn't work with certain games. It makes everything look smaller. All of those things I figured out. However, my recording software was incompatible with the 4K monitor. So what it was trying to record the 4K monitor's resolution output, but couldn't. So it was... What it was doing was... The actual frame rate was knackered. So then I thought, what I'll do is record. I swear I've described all this before. But anyway, yeah, it's cut a long story short. Too late. I've got action. And what happened with action was I made sure everything was tested fine. I made sure everything was working fine. And then... I thought, yeah, everything's great, everything's working, because Fraps wasn't working properly, and, little shithead, fucking die. Right over his head. Fraps wasn't working properly, I couldn't get DX Story to work properly, and then I found out that they were incompatible with Adobe... editor that I was using, that I used to edit the videos together, because Adobe doesn't like to use what's the one with the full frames per second, and the other one where when you've got the frames going click 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 click, click, and they're all there, so they all the frames make up pictures, but there's some that what they do is they some recorders what they do is they record missing frames to save space, and then your nope. See, this is where cock ups happen. So the missing frames don't add there. So the whatever editing software you use kind of goes, oh well, just use up frames from either side and sort of fill the gap. Whereas Adobe does not like to do that. Does not like to do that in any way, shape, or form. So I had to faff about, lots of faffing, with extra faffing, and then finally I got Action, which is a decent recorder, can record the dual, whatchamacallit, die little shit it. And then I fucked that up.